downtown Los Angeles. People head here to work, shop, and eat. There's plenty of food to be had, including this bad boy. Meet the bacon-wrapped hot dog. Top it with anything you like, and you've got yourself one of LA's proudest gastronomical traditions.
It tastes so good, and it's so bad for you, you might think it's illegal. Actually, it is.
Welcome to the underground world of black market bacon dogs. Okay, it's not really underground. You see food carts like this all over the place, and there's bigger ones too. Some vendors will sell you an illegal bacon dog, but hardly any will talk about it.
She doesn't want to talk.
The owner of this cart wouldn't talk, but she responded to our questions through one of her customers, Fabiella.
2 weeks ago, somebody spoke to the news, somebody in the news, and that's why they were harassed. And they're trying to get rid of them.
And who is trying to get rid of them?
The health department.
The vendor tells Fabiella that the health department has been cracking down on bacon dog sellers.
They've been arrested. The food is basically thrown in the trash can. Everything they have, they throw it in the trash.
We saw it ourselves. The cops confiscated these carts. The dogs were dumped. And then the carts tossed into the garbage truck. Now, why in the world would officials want to mess with something that's so delicious? It all starts with the salty strip that wraps around the hot dog.
Doing bacon is illegal.
Elizabeth Palacios is one of the few vendors willing to speak publicly.
I used to do that before, but health department doesn't allow that.
She's been selling bacon dogs and other food for about 20 years. She pays taxes and is required to have 3 different kinds of permits.
City permits, health department permits, and border equalization permits.
She's used the money she's made to raise her daughter, buy a car, and a house.
No, I love to sell. This is my life. I like to be with customers, to talk to them. I feel proud of myself.
But with run-ins with the health department and police officers, Palacios worries about the future. She says she loses business if she doesn't give customers the bacon they demand.
They want bacon. They want to buy it with bacon.
It just gives it like an extra taste, the crispiness of the bacon and just the flavors together. It's just wonderful.
Bacon is a potential hazardous food.
Terrence Powell of the LA County Health Department.
Potentially hazardous foods, by definition, are those foods that, if not kept within certain limits, whether it be temperature or pH control, acidity, would allow for the growth of harmful bacteria that would get you sick.
So how many people are getting sick from these bacon dogs?
That's kind of a nebulous number.
We don't know how many cases of food sickness come from eating out versus eating at home, so no one really knows if these dogs are dangerous. But Powell says customers expect food to be safe.
That they're not going to be locked up in their restroom at home because they ate a hot dog that was improperly cooked or improperly stored.
Well said, Terrence. Our cameraman, Alex, bravely agreed to an experiment that would test the bacon dog's effect on the human body. Actually, Alex was wolfing down dogs long before we aimed the cameras at him, but we'll still give him credit for advancing science. We'll check on Alex later. Gee, I hope he's okay. But Powell says that Palacios can sidestep this controversy and sell bacon dogs legally. How? Get rid of her old cart and buy a sleek new one like this that comes with new features like a 3-compartment sink.
So that you can wash, rinse, and sanitize any of the equipment that's being used, utensils and the like.
The new cart cost is like $26,000. How I can afford it?
The new cart is about 5 times as expensive as the cart Palacios has now. But if she sells bacon dogs without it, she faces the inevitable stiff consequences.
It's $1,000 or 6 months in jail. And we will summarily take individuals to court if they violate the law.
They took Palacios to court about a year ago after catching her cooking bacon dogs.
I have to pay a lawyer.
The judge sentenced her to 45 days in jail.
It was a black day for me.
Meanwhile, Alex is still downing dogs with no ill effects, and we didn't find anyone who has gotten sick from bacon dogs.
I never got sick.
I never gotten sick, and you know, I think the people that sell hot dogs really helping us.
But we are in the business of preventing people from getting sick, and we will do that.
Of course, it is possible that the bacon hot dogs might have made some people sick. But in addition to what might have happened, maybe, shouldn't we also consider what we know for sure is happening to people like Elizabeth Palacios?
So all that money is getting me behind my bills. And right now I'm broke. I'm still broke. Almost 1 year.
1 year after getting busted, she's still deep in debt from paying attorney's fees and fines. And because she was unable to work for 45 days.
It is like really, really amazing that over 12 months I've been laying on my mortgage.
Now she worries that she'll lose her house and points to the vendors with the tiny carts.
They do a lot of more money than I do.
She says if she doesn't sell bacon dogs, customers will buy from them. And you don't have to be Ben Bernanke to know that she's right.
And they said, do you have bacon? And I said, no. They said, oh, thank you. And they called with whoever has bacon.
She loses money, and the goal of protecting consumers doesn't turn out the way officials wanted, shock, because unlike Elizabeth, these vendors aren't licensed at all.
They don't care about if you're cleaner, if you don't have license, if you don't have a license to handle the food. They just want the bacon.
That's right, Elizabeth. They just want the bacon. For Reason.TV, I'm Drew Carey.